Vicky here. So in this video, I am working on trellising up the tomatoes. I don't know the best, maybe staking them, I'm not sure, but they needed a little bit more support than what my twine all by itself was giving them. And I also needed to prune the lowest branches of the tomato plants. I'm not sure if branches is necessarily the right word, but I had quite a few leaves that were touching the ground, and some of them looked, you know, a little waterlogged, a little diseased, a little not so great. So I definitely wanted to get those lowest branches up off the ground and essentially off the plant. So what I did is I took these tomato stakes and I weaved it sort of in between my twine right next to the main stem of the plant so that it would be sort of right there to help support the plants. And I think that was a good decision. I also took some extra twine and I really worked to tie up some of the more spread out branches. And the reason I did that is sort of twofold. One, to add support to the branch so that as tomatoes, you know, start growing, it has a little bit more sturdiness to it. But also because I do have other plants at the front of these beds, at least in the front of three of them. And those plants also need some sunlight. So by taking the branches and sort of training them towards these red stakes, it does help with that. So, with like not shading out the other plants. So those were my main goals. I also did add a couple more layers of the twine weave around these plants so that they would be, you know, well supported and ready to grow. But all in all, it was a pretty easy process. Yes, I am wearing a dress. Would I recommend that for gardening attire? Maybe not, okay? Maybe not. But sometimes you just got to get stuff done when you have time. And sometimes when you have time, you are not necessarily dressed appropriately. So you just work with what you got. All right. I just wanted to make some comments there because, yes, I recognize this might be not the best choice. But, oh well. It's fine. The dress washed. So, anywho, that's what we're working on here. And, yeah, I'll kind of let the video sort of speak for itself, but thank you and, hope you enjoy.
All right, so I'm actually pretty happy with this one. We're getting some storms tonight, so I think it will help that it is more stable. Let's hit the ones in the back. They need a lot more help.
Come here, come here. Can I catch the butterfly?
You can try. So this is why I am trimming the lower branches. The ones that are touching the ground are already just not looking so great.
Okay.
All right. Might be kind of tough to see from this angle, but we're gonna work on these first. Thread this, I'm looking to go kind of right next to the stem, and I also want to go in between some of the threads I've already, or the twine that's already in there. All right, I'm gonna work on this one first. It is the worst of what we have available to work on. Let me find where I put my twine. All right. To do here is locate the branches down here at the bottom that need to not be on the bottom, and I'm going to tie those to the red post. Now this basil can see for the first time in a week. We'll also be doing some pruning, but I don't really want to prune too heavily, especially when I'm fairly confident we can make it do what we need it to do. All right. So now that we can see, I'm just going to try to take the leaves that are touching the earth at the bottom. Some of these are already yellowed or looking a little diseased, so they're certainly not serving our plant. We're just going to keep, as we get these tendrils sort of located, I'm just going to keep tying them up. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to be on the red post. This one I'm tying on the twine. Just needs to be up. Here's another pretty big branch here, this one, that decided it did not want to behave. I'm going to squish that grass for just a second. And tying this one up to the twine as well. At this point, it's just the most convenient place to tie it. Alright, that is looking better, but not quite there for sure. This one tomato might be the worst out of the whole garden. It kind of just splayed out in all sorts of directions. Tie up, it gets a little easier to see what it is that needs to be pruned away. Right. So I think what actually will serve us best right now is to add another row here. That way we have more supports to tie the tomato to. So, perfect. definitely a night and day difference. Beans can actually see.
Well, these are sharp.
Band-aid for that. Band-aid acquired. All right, where were we? Now this isn't looking like much yet. But we really are making a lot of progress. I can actually see the beans now and what has and hasn't sprouted. So it looks like I can actually plant a few more that did not come up. Let's see what we have going on in the back.
the ladybug.
There's a ladybug down there. Cool. Right. It's definitely getting a lot better. Wow, there's a lot of little creatures living underneath my pot. Interesting. Don't know if that's good or bad. Okie dokie. See the ladybug? Oh, it just flew away. Didn't fly far though. Okay. So we are gonna tie these wherever it makes sense. Honestly, the wind's already picking up for this storm, so I'm glad to have this chore task underway. I do think that these plants will fare a lot better actually being supported. They grew really rapidly, to be honest. Just last weekend, like I was thinking, yeah, I gotta do something, but it wasn't dire. And this weekend, just 1 week later, we really needed to do something else for this. Honestly, that's looking way better. Way, way better. I think I'm happy with these. Now, turns out I miscounted and I do not have enough support stakes. I don't know why I thought I only needed 16, but I did, and I need more than that. So we only have one available to put in the last bed, but we're gonna do that right now, just so this is all done to the extent that we can do it. All right, for the last bed, there we go. I've elected to put it right in the middle. I don't know. At the moment, it just feels like the best choice. So we're gonna do that. We're definitely gonna add another layer here. right, so that I think will add a little more stability in general. And now we'll try to work on the one plant we do have a stake for. Okay, did some pruning. Don't want to do too much because I might be able to tie up a lot of the branches down there. I did find a worm, though. Caterpillar of some sort. All right, the other thing I need to do, I think, probably thin out this lettuce a little bit. Might save that for tomorrow. The beans in this bed are looking a little better, but I do think they've been struggling, probably with so much shade from this. Does look better. Do a little pruning on the back.
See, like this, I don't need that. Up here and in my boot. Okay, so I think that's looking a lot better. I pruned more than maybe I intended, but I was concerned about some of what I saw down there in terms of leaf health. So I think it was a good decision. And this one is in apparently the shadiest spot in the whole garden. So I do think it will be more prone to pests and things. Alright, I think we're ready for that storm now. So yeah, little garden task for the day. Need two more posts because I can't count. But we're getting there. Until next time, bye!